just got out of class and I'm driving home. I didn't just get out of class. I was talking to Dee and a few other people. We don't have the same class, but we do. We are in the building at the same time, so I ran into him. Class is good. I'm just like, I don't know. We're all feeling kind of exhausted because we have to readjust our bodies because our, you know, we were basically going to bed when we were waking. When we now have to wake up, back to reality. So that's good. Today was really interesting. My students were, I don't know, just really, like, one of them was just being, like, really lazy. The other was, oh, fuck, I gotta take this call. Hold on. Okay, sorry about that. I just finished a screaming match. It's good. Good things. I guess it's really hard for certain men to accept that I am doing things to better myself and that I'm capable of taking care of myself, and I don't feel the need to bow down 180% to a man, but that I'm extremely loyal and extremely good to somebody when they're good to me. And it seems as if men have a hard time being able to provide less than me, and then expect me to need to be really needy because of it in other aspects, and I'm not that way. I don't understand that mentality, to be like really needy. And I feel like if you could do things for yourself, why should you just rely on a man to do it for you all the time if you have the ability? Because I feel like you set yourself up for failure, because if something happens, whether it's like he leaves you or God forbid something happens to him or whatever, and you're not capable of doing it because you never learned yourself, that's just really dumb on your part. And I would never want to be that way. And I've always been taught to be independent financially. So I've always taken care of myself. And it seems as though a lot of men have a really difficult time accepting that. And it bothers them. And I'm very strong-willed, and I'm very aware of what it is that I want, and not that it's not negotiable. I'm flexible, and I am able to compromise. I'm not saying I'm perfect. I mean, obviously I have plenty of flaws, and I sometimes am hard-headed, and it is difficult for me to compromise on certain issues, but I am willing to try to do my best to compromise and try to meet somebody halfway. But I guess I'm a little too strong-willed for some people. And so when everything comes to a head, it becomes this like crazy thing that it shouldn't be. And I don't take kindly to people trying to be real foul and say foul shit to me because their feelings are hurt or whatever. I didn't even do anything to hurt someone's feelings, but for whatever reason, they felt the need to say foul shit to me because they weren't getting the responses that they wanted. And I just don't appreciate that. I don't respect that. And so I was on some, like, well, goodbye, because I'm not about to sit here and listen to somebody try to be just ridiculous. And so, oh God, what that led to, basically, was real nasty kind of argument, which I don't enjoy getting into, and I find to be really useless, because nothing ever tends to get accomplished when things are so heated and you have an argument like that. It's like no one's gonna get heard, so you're basically yelling out loud for nothing. Because if you're so angry that you can't absorb anything that the other person is saying to you, then how can you possibly compromise? It doesn't even make sense. It was a useless conversation, argument, or whatever. And I just am, I'm done having it. So that's that. That's over and done. And I'm still being called, but, it's 10:30 and I'm now home. So I'm going to go inside and I don't know, see what's going on inside.